In Monolix Suite 2023, it is now possible to generate a report automatically for a peak analytics or a Monolix project. Let's focus today on examples in Monolix. Here is a Monolix project with results. I have a PK dataset with 32 individuals who received a single dose of warfarin at time zero. I developed a PK model and I have results for all tasks. Population parameters with their standard errors for two different methods. Individual parameters obtained by estimating the EBEs or the mean of the conditional distribution, and likelihood. To see how I developed a model and found good results for this dataset, you can check the Monolix typical workflow video. I have also selected here which plots to generate in addition to observed data plots. First, I will now generate a report with a default structure to centralize the main results and all the plots in a Word document that I can easily comment and share with my colleagues. Let's look at the plots and customize them a bit to have them exactly as I want in the report. For the observed data, I can, for example, color lines by groups of weight and display the legend. I can also maybe replace the axis labels by time in hours and warfarin concentration in milligram per liter. Okay, let's say that's it for observed data. I can also customize a bit the covariate viewer. For example, here I want to include only weight in my report but not the log transformed weight. So I'm going to select here symmetrical selection and remove the transformed covariate from the plot. I have the observations versus predictions, where I usually want to have the x and y axis in log scale. So I'm going to set the log scale here on the x and on the y axis. On my distribution of individual parameters, I want to display the shrinkage. And for individual parameters versus covariates, I want to keep only the log transformed weight and not the weight. So I'm going here to remove weight from the covariates in this plot. Finally, on the VPC, I want to display the legend and replace also the axis labels by the ones I used in the observed data plots. Okay, so now that all plots are exactly as I want, I will generate a report by clicking on Export, Generate Report. Let's generate the default report first. A Word document is now generated next to my project file, but I could also select another location if I wanted. In this default report, I have the table of population parameters and the likelihood table with titles and the plots that I customized in the interface with their own caption. The plots in the report have everything zoomed in, font size, line widths, and so on, to have them easily readable in a document. This quickly generated report is usually not the final report of a project, but it provides a quick way to share the results or a starting point for the final report. To generate a more custom report, you can provide your own Word template and tell Monolix to add plots and tables in that document. What is a template exactly? An example of Word template can be downloaded with this button. This is the template file used by Monolix to generate the default report for this project. Let me display this template on the left and the report we obtained on the right. First, we see keywords surrounded by percentage signs. These keywords have been replaced by their value for the current project and today's date. To use keywords in a custom template, you can refer to the list of reporting keywords available on Monolix website. Many keywords are available to report systematically the settings used to generate the results, dataset-related information, or the code used for the structural model, and so on. For example, if I take here the keyword for structural model code, I could add here a section showing the code for the structural model. I can format this keyword as I want, and the formatting will be kept when Monolix replaces the keywords by its values. In the table section, this whole bunch of text surrounded by Lixoft PLH words is what we call a placeholder. When generating the report, the placeholder has been replaced by the table of population parameters. The content of the placeholder defines what will appear exactly in the generated table. The next placeholder below has been replaced by the table of likelihood results. And if I keep scrolling down, I now have another placeholder for the observed data plot, another one for the covariate viewer, etc. And each element that you want to have in your report should be included in your template as a placeholder containing all the information needed to reproduce the element. So to use custom templates, you need to prepare a Word document like this with placeholders. You don't need to write them from scratch. Every table and every plot that is relevant for a report has a button next to it to add it to a report template. So for example, to add another table to my report template, which currently includes only population parameters and likelihood, I can go to that table. So for example, if I want to include EBEs, I will copy the placeholder by clicking on that icon and copy to clipboard. And now I go to my report template and I add this placeholder after the table of population parameters. By default, the placeholder will generate a table that looks like in the interface, but this can be changed. For instance, I can remove the display of the covariates by writing none instead of all, and I can increase the number of significant digits to 3. Let me show you now the placeholder for a plot. So for example, we can look at the observed data. The placeholder encodes all the customization done in the interface. If I change the plot settings, for example, to remove coloring, set the log scale on the y-axis, and focus the axis limits on the elimination, the placeholder is updated. You see that I have a log scale on the y-axis, axis limits updated, and there is no coloring by weight anymore in that placeholder. I could copy this new placeholder into my template to show the observed data in log scale in addition to the previous observed data plot. But before I do this, I would like to show you a few additional options in the placeholder which enable to tune how the plot will appear in the report. So width and height enable to tune the width of the plot in the Word document. An aspect ratio can be locked to keep the same dimensions as the ones I see on the screen. For example, I can choose to have a smaller plot that is 12 centimeters wide and the height has just been updated. If you prefer to work with inches, it is also possible. To check the impact of this change, I can click on Preview to generate a Word document with only that figure. So now you see that the plot width is indeed 12 centimeters. The zoom enables to tune how much all font sizes, line widths will be increased in the report to make the plot readable in a document. For example, here I find that the labels are still too small. I can increase the zoom value to 150 and check how it looks with the preview again. This looks better to me in the report. The caption enables to have custom text instead of the default name of the plot, which is observed data in this case. Let me call it individual blood concentration time profiles in log scale. And after making this change, I can do a last preview. So now that I'm happy with the preview for this plot, I can copy this placeholder to the report template, and I'm going to put it just below the first plot for observed data. In the template, I can also write text that will not be replaced and use keyword placeholders within sentences. For example, if I write warfarin concentrations have been collected for data subjects with a total of data observations, here total number of subjects will be replaced by the actual number in the project, and same thing for the total number of observations, but the rest will not be touched. I will save this new template somewhere on my computer. And let's now generate a new report with the custom template. I don't need to have this exact run, I can have any other run, so I'm going to load a project that doesn't have all these customizations that I have done, just to show you. In this project, I have not even generated the result plots. but I have results for all the tasks. So I'm going to generate a report again, and this time I select the custom option and I select the template that I just created. I have this additional option to select some table style. The names that you can select here are the default styles in Microsoft Word. So I can choose, for example, plain table 4. It is also possible to use your own Word table styles inside the placeholders if you always use the same style in your reports. I generate the custom report now. I now have a new report generated which is more custom than the default report. Monolix replaced the keywords that I used in that sentence by the actual numbers. It also replaced the keyword for the structural model by the text for the structural model, keeping the fonts and the font size that I decided to have. The table now have a different style that I selected for report generation. And I have the table of individual parameters since I inserted this placeholder into the template. I can also see the observed data in log scale and in a smaller plot and with custom axis limits, since I customized all this in the interface before copying the placeholder for that plot. To show you how a fully custom report would look like after working a bit more on a template, I will download an example template for warfarin on the website. This template looks like a typical pharmacokinetic report. It has a summary, methods and results, and a list of tables and a list of figures that will be updated when tables are added by the report generation. So let me use now this template for this run. So you see now that the list of tables and list of figures have been updated. I also have custom plots and tables in that report. The same template can be used for several Monolix runs. So if I, for instance, change my model, add a cover yet effect, save as another project and rerun, I can now generate a report for this new run too by just loading the same template file. It is possible to script the generation of reports either from R with the connector generate report or directly from the command line with the report generator function. This can be useful to generate reports for many projects. However, note that reports generated via connectors or via the command line will not include any plots. I hope you enjoy the new reporting feature. Give us your feedback, please, in the comments or at feedback@lixoft.com to help us continuously improve your experience.